If you've ever had to work with mesh entities, you probably know that not all meshes are created equal. Meshes generated from model assemblies can often be bulky and have issues with overlapping facets or bloated triangle counts due to tolerancing or translation effects. MasterCAM 2022 has several methods of addressing each of these scenarios, so let's dive in and examine some common approaches. I have a mesh model displayed of a carton for a blow mold assembly. The mesh itself has quite a bit of detail, far more than we need or could use. I can click on the carton and use F4 to analyze entity to see that it's made up of around 250,000 facets. This carton mesh represents a large percentage of the overall file size, and I'd like to simplify it for future use. I'll also go to the View tab and expand the Appearance options to find and turn on Show Triangle Edges. This gives me a good visual of the facet composition on the mesh itself. Turning off the blow mold level, the first thing I notice is the extraneous facets at the top of the carton. I'll launch the Modify Mesh Facets command to address these. I'll choose Remove Facets for the operation type, and then move on to select the target facets. If I snap to the front view here and try to left-click and drag to scrub and select these facets, you can see that I'm actually only getting the front facets in the selection and missing the facets on the flange backside of this orifice. I'll go back to the facet selection panel and enable Wrap Around Mesh, which changes my selection to allow me to pick anything under the brush, no matter if it is obscured or under another layer. It's essentially a selection beam that shoots through the entire model to find facets. Now I can quickly scrub across these flange facets and click OK to finish up my selection. Then OK again to accept the deletion. Now, before I can use any complex mesh commands on a mesh, it has to be error-free. I'll verify this using the Check Mesh command. Once I select the carton, I see in the results list that I have two degenerate faces, and they're marked on the carton with a red wireframe point. I'll click OK to accept the results and keep the red points on the screen as a reference. Going back into Modify Mesh Facets, this time I'll use the Repair operation type and zoom in and use the brush to scrub the problem facet and adjacent facets. Make sure to turn off Wrap Around Mesh so that we're only selecting the face where the problem is. I'll click OK to accept that selection and OK again to accept the repair. Then perform this repair again for the second point. Now, if I run Check Mesh again, I can see that we have zero errors with the mesh, and we're ready to move on to other, more involved mesh editing techniques. Let's launch the Decimation command from the Mesh tab on the ribbon. I'll select the carton mesh to decimate, and then look at the options on this panel. Decimation will attempt to simplify your selected mesh and reduce overall facet count while following the values the user specifies. Preservation angle is a measure of how much decimation is allowed to move adjacent facets when simplifying the model. Organic shapes will need larger preservation angles, and prismatic shapes will need smaller preservation angles to keep general mesh intent intact while using this command. Reduction goal is your overall percentage target of facet count reduction. Decimation will reduce facet count by up to this much if the other calculation parameters allow it to. Approximate facet shift is a value that limits the overall shift or change in the mesh surface allowed when performing a decimation. I'm going to set a preservation angle of 20 degrees a reduction goal of 50%, and an approximate facet shift value of 0.2, then hit preview. We can see in the results here that we met our goal of reducing the mesh facet count by half. I'll click OK to finish up and accept the results. When doing major mesh edits and drastically altering the facets, it's possible to inadvertently create degenerate points or faces with your requested tolerances. Because of this, it's always a good idea to quickly run check mesh. I see I've created another degenerate face, so I'll go into Modify Mesh Facets one more time and perform another spot repair to readjust the facets and fix the issue. Once the mesh is ready to be worked on again, we'll launch the Refine command. Refine is used to rearrange the facet concentration of a model. Let's use a preservation angle of 5, an average edge length of 15, and one maximum iteration, and then hit preview to get a good idea of the anisotropic result. Anisotropic refinement will attempt to fit larger facets to areas of less detail and smaller facets to areas of finer detail. The gamma value is a weighting factor that generates a greater number of facets in all areas the larger the gamma value is that the user inputs. The anisotropic result here is changing the surface too radically in the handle area. So let's try the isotropic method, which attempts to fit uniform facets across the entire mesh. I'll change up the preservation angle to 1 degree, average edge length to 10, and maximum iterations to 5, and then hit preview. We've got a good mix of detail in the contoured handle and fillet areas, and large, even facets on the flatter areas that have gotten rid of our long sliver facets from the original mesh. The values you'll need to use in this command will vary depending on the shape of your mesh and your goals with the refinement, so don't be afraid to experiment with different values in the command options. I'll click OK to accept the results and finish up. Our changes here have taken 10 megabytes out of the MasterCam file size and given us a much nicer mesh to move forward with, all with the new Mesh Tool Suite in MasterCam 2022.